Welcome to another tutorial on MATLAB. In this particular tutorial series, we are looking into the MAAB guideline and how we can implement MAAB guidelines in MATLAB. In this particular tutorial, we will see where we can find the MAAB guideline in MATLAB software and what are the different additional guidelines that are available along with MAAB guidelines so that we can do the checks for the same also. So the main focus over here is to understand the MAAB guideline. So let's see where it is exactly present in the MATLAB software. So to open any MAAB guideline, you need to open first Simulink. And for that, you need to type Simulink and open a blank Simulink model window. And in that, maybe here in our case, we will be creating a simple addition block, which will add two constant blocks. The first constant block value will be 1, and the second one will be of the value 2. And we will be adding this to with the help of the add block. And using that add block, we will complete the model creation. So basically, this is a simple model. And we will add a scope so that we can see some outcome from the calculation that is happening inside the model. And based on that, so we will just save the model and we will see the MAAB guidelines now where it is actually present for the model. So basically, you need to have a Simulink model to check all your MAAB guidelines. And based on that, you can see what are the guidelines that are being followed in creating your model or not. So for this, you need to go to the analysis tab, and in the analysis tab, you will have a model advisory. So there you need to select your model, press OK, and then the checks will be loaded. And here is two blocks. So by task and by product, and inside this you will find different type of guidelines like DO178C, D, something like that. And also along with that you will find JMAAB and MAAB. So inside MAAB, you can see there are different types of conventions mentioned. First is naming convention. So inside naming convention, all these scripts are there which will do the checks. You need to tick on the checkboxes which you want to run and which you do not want to run. You need to uncheck them. The model architecture checks, and then the model configuration options check. So these will check the model configuration that you have according to the MAAB guideline. And then Simulink. So this will be a little larger checks. So many checks will be there for this particular section. And then you will have a state flow check. So here you will have all the state flow related checks. And next you have MATLAB functions related checks. So these are the checks that are present in the MAAB guideline, and using these checks you can do compliance with the model advisory guidelines for your model. So the entire series is being divided into multiple chapters which are related to naming convention, model architecture, model configuration, Simulink, state flow, and MATLAB functions. So this is how the entire tutorial is being organized, and you can go through individual checks that are there in this particular topic, and manually also you need to check many things. So in here, maybe some of the model advisory checks will not be available because it is not possible to automate everything, but you can do the checks from your side and maintain a good compliance to the MAAB guideline so that you can develop a good model based on the MAAB guidelines. In case you have any comment or query, please let us know in the comment section. And yeah, stay subscribed to the channel. Happy learning MATLAB, and stay connected. Thank you.